to me, and it did. And I'm not gonna disappoint. I'll tell you that much.
Did you go to Vegas starting with Lovers and Friends, and then going into the residency, saying like, okay, if we do all this, now that it's here, the Super Bowl is going to be next. Like, was that like a, like you kind of, you put that out there knowing that this would come? Kind of like a proof of concept type of thing. Not that you needed it, but you know what I mean?
Yeah, no, affirmations. Like, literally deciding that I was going to move in a certain way to take, like, some sense of ownership of a space. You know, I feel like in the past, being able to do that in Atlanta. Like, yeah, I'm originally from Chattanooga, Tennessee, but I was raised in Atlanta. And Atlanta raised the artist that I am. Atlanta raised the man that I am. Atlanta raised the person and the creative that I am. And I was able to do that in Las Vegas. So I started with the residency, opening a show when we were just coming out of the pandemic, the first show to open in the world, not just United States of America, but yo, we were coming out of a pandemic and people were afraid, you know, bringing that energy back in, that started it. And then staying in Las Vegas long enough for them to decide, okay, we're gonna have the Super Bowl in Las Vegas. So I'm like, I'm staying here. I brought my festival, you know, Lovers and Friends to Vegas. I was like, I'm staying here. I'm going to put my flag down here. This is my new space. This is my home. I feel like I get to do all of the things that I've always wanted to do and progress and just be creative. And since then, there's just been more and more things that have just really worked to my benefit.
Lil Mo Films, you watching the Chitlin' Circuit. Y'all know what it is.
Lil Mo Films.